And next, another sports story of sorts. Why the economic hopes of a Midwestern city are tied to the fortune and decision of a basketball superstar, a guy by the name of LeBron James. Economics correspondent Paul Solman has the story. It's part of his series on making sense of financial news.
The Cavaliers. Red-hot attraction in Cleveland, Ohio the past few years, and key to the city's efforts to rebound from Rust Belt ruin to post-industrial prosperity. Leading the charge, local high school phenom, now league MVP, LeBron James. The reason the Cavs sell 20,000 seats a game at, on average, $80 each, some $1.5 million a night. In a global economy, James is a global draw. The Baryshnikov of buckets, Houdini of hoops, Rembrandt of the rim. But the King of the Court's contract is up July 1st, freeing him to sign with any team in the league for millions of dollars and the brighter lights of a bigger city. And thus, the economic question that's put Cleveland on hold has become the talk of the sports world. Will LeBron go or stay put? Set Cleveland back or help restore something of its glorious past? A Great Lakes port on the Cuyahoga River, Cleveland was once home to steel mills, car plants, manufacturers galore. Its art museum still boasts splendors from the fat years. Monet's water lilies, Frederick Church's Twilight in the Wilderness.
Burn on, big river, burn on.
Cleveland's twilight came in the 1960s, kicked off by an oil and debris fire on the Cuyahoga River, which became a parody pop hit, making Cleveland a national joke. As Ohio industry lost out to cutting-edge competition from elsewhere, so did Cleveland sports teams. But then, in 2003, along came James, who grew up in Akron, 30 miles south of Cleveland, and is now a potential selling point for the region in an increasingly service-driven global economy. Team President Len Komorowski says James has helped turn the Cleveland Cavaliers into an international brand.
We have fans who come here and make the sojourn to Cleveland from all over the world. We're one of the most heavily televised teams in our league, both nationally as well as internationally. And even in China this past year, we were on 34 times in China.
With a TV audience in China of 100 million a game. Restaurant owner Terry Tarantino recalls his travels to Turkey just 8 years ago.
No one really knew where Cleveland was. They knew it was, maybe, is it close to New York? Is it close to Chicago? Now LeBron James gets on the team. Where are you from? I'm from Cleveland. You ever hear of Cleveland? Come on, man, I know Cleveland, LeBron James.
Pre-LeBron, the Cavs sold less than 12,000 seats a night. Now almost double that. Throw in all the extras you buy when you spend hours at the arena, the now soaring TV revenues, suites for the high rollers.
And how much if my company buys one of these for a year?
It will range somewhere between $300,000 to $400,000 per year.
It all makes James worth far more than the $16 million a year the Cavs pay him, and maybe even more still to Cleveland, Ohio.
LeBron definitely brings a different crowd down here, a good crowd.
Good?
A good spending crowd.
Doug Petkovic co-owns upscale Lola, a minute from the Cavs arena on a street that's now hopping.
Would we be hurt if LeBron's not playing and those people aren't coming? We'd certainly feel some of that impact.
Just up the block, Flannery's.
So pre-LeBron, LeBron.
Wow, big difference. We weren't a basketball town. Flannery's would get 4 to 6 tables in here, sometimes 20, big night. When LeBron came, we went to an hour wait for a 7 o'clock game, doing 400 to 600 dinners. So huge.
Soccer fans packed Flannery's when we were there, but LeBron anxiety was still in the air.
How much of a difference does it make economically to Cleveland if LeBron leaves?
It just has a huge, huge difference in the way people feel.
I think it's going to be a tremendous deal. I think everyone knows it's a huge economic loss, I think, for the whole city of Cleveland if he leaves.
Consider the TV audience, says the Cavs president.
People who have never been to Cleveland before, this is what they see. And they see these beautiful shots of the city. And you can tune in to any game that we have, and you're going to find examples of this.
The value of the imagery? Priceless, says Cleveland Mayor Frank Jackson.
There's no way that you can pay for that kind of marketing in China or in Europe.
Or anywhere in
anywhere
America.
In America. You couldn't pay for that.
No wonder local Cleveland officials and celebs actually made a We Are LeBron internet video pleading with their 26-year-old meal ticket. Copyright issues have since removed the video from most websites, but Clevelanders refuse to be silenced.
LeBron, you should stay because we love you, and you love the city. Hands down, that's it. End the story.
Stay, baby. We love you, man. We love you.
And you need him?
And we definitely need him.
Mayor Jackson, now in his second term, has resolved to revive a city riddled with subprime foreclosures. James taking the Cavs to the playoffs five straight years has been a real help.
The average person on the street is still suffering. And as a result of that, cities are still in financial situations that are not too healthy for us. And so to have this kind of pride and to have this kind of success, it really, in many cases, helps people in cities and institutions get past a moment.
Kent State Professor Mark Lieberger has put a number on the team's value to the city.
Look at the 98-point-some million that the Cavaliers generate in revenue, and we plug those into the equation. When we look at everything across the board, there is a significant economic impact. It's about $140 million.
A year. But beyond the immediate cash boost to Cleveland, the Cavaliers franchise has grown by more than $200 million in value since James arrived. And then there's the psychological lift the mayor mentioned, which by itself can lead to more spending, more investing, and a higher quality of life.
Unless we did a survey to interview, you know, consumers on the street and ask that specific question, it would really be difficult to quantify that.
So we did a survey, collecting anecdata. How much would random Clevelanders be willing to pay if that would somehow keep LeBron?
I don't think I would pay anything. Probably zero.
Eavesdropping, restaurateur Tarantino thought these customers were nuts.
But how much would you personally pay out of your own pocket?
How much would I pay out of my pocket? Probably $1,000. I don't know.
And he wasn't the only big spender.
I would go $5,000 for LeBron.
Now, league rules allow the Cavs to offer LeBron $30 million more than any other team. So, as another Cleveland icon might now be wondering, will he or won't he? Sports writer Brian Windhorst.
You wrote a book about him. You know him. What's he going to do?
I think he'll make a lot of people here sweat. And I think he'll give a lot of people in other cities hope. But I think ultimately he stays home because it is home.
LeBron's hometown of Akron, struggling economically as well. The Rubber City has also put on a full court press. And last week threw its own LeBron Appreciation Day.
LeBron, you have to stay here. You're our king. You're our hero. Bring that ring to Cleveland.
It'll be a banner day for the Northeast Ohio economy if he sticks around to give Cleveland a shot.